shirt this year. Team. So with 11 seconds left, we're going to throw 78. Scott Brown throws a strike here to Kirk Phillips, number 21. And Kirk has got great speed. He's 4.5 40. He made a great catch over his shoulder and took it in for 77-yard touchdown pass run.
Look at it again on slow motion. You'll see Kirk's going to catch this in full stride. Scott Brown lays it up beautiful.
What a job Scott Brown did last night for the Hurricanes. Just put this right on the money. Coach, you can't draw it up any better than this. It's right on the money.
And we cut to our downstairs camera, and you see he gathers it in over his shoulder in full stride, and there's no defensive back going to catch him when he's at full flight like that.
Jerry, just a great football play, and we played great offense last night, but I'll tell you what else we did. We played great defense, too. We really did.
Now watch Ken Lacy beat him to death on the ground.
Get after him, Ken. You know, that is... They're going to kick off, and it's going to backfire. They want to get good field position. They kick the ball off to Kirk Phillips. This is a good return. We get good blocking, take it out to the 30-yard line. We're going to start off here now. Scott Brown, our junior quarterback, is at the quarterback position right now. Run wing left, we call it 47, toss it back to Mike Gunner. Counter option. Ken Lacy for short yardage. Here's a quick pass out in the flat here to David Hershey, number 82. Good block by Kurt Steinauer, number 80. Good yardage. Now Scott's doing a great job. He's just like Skip Ash, doing a great job reading the defense, hand the ball off to Gunner.
Gunner got 13 that shot.
We read the tackle on that particular play. Watch Lacy block. Oh. I'll tell you what a football player Ken Lacy is. Just a great block. He owned the linebacker all night, Jerry.
A little scramble here.
A little scramble, and you can't see it there, but they tackled our tight end. That's the play we got where we're going to look at the tight end. If he's open, we're going to get the football to him. Their safety tackled Kurt Steinauer, so obviously that's a 10-yard penalty. Here's a tall sweep back to Mike Gunner. Gunner takes it down for good yardage. First down.
Tulsa is going to
Jerry, look at this effort. Look at this effort by Scott Brown. He would not be denied. That guy got a hold of him as an all-conference defensive end. Made 14 tackles in last week's ball game.
Right. And was player of the week in the valley.
Just a great play by Scott Brown, number 13. You can see how happy our offensive team is.
Now, we showed you that extra point because it is a new conference record of 108 right there, and we've just started.
108. Stu has missed one extra point in his whole career, 108 out of 109. We kick off, and we don't do a very good job covering here. They're going to have the ball in good field position. Coach Jones, we're going to have to play some defense. They come out smoking here early.
That kickoff set the tone for this defensive series. They got good field position, and defense just wasn't ready to play the first series.
Well, I'm not sure. I think we're ready to play. It's just a fact. They're doing a good job here. They've got a good offensive football team. That's Banks, big running back, number 25, Jerry. He's gone over 100 yards now in three consecutive ball games.
This time we're going to give it to the Dwinger, who is their other back.
Oh, look at Brian Bruner, number 96. Get after him, Brian, nose guard.
We changed about defense there. We brought the nose guard weak instead of strong, and he made a big play.
I told Bruner, I took his gloves off at halftime, Jerry. I said, you don't need those gloves on the play, but he made a pretty good play there with them on, didn't he? Get after him, defense. That's number 62, Bob Babich, our linebacker, senior linebacker. What a great career Babich has had. Kevin Lilly, number 77, on the bottom of the pile.
Banks is a good back.
Banks is a good back. Pretty good play here, Coach Jones.
That's a great play. He blocked the end. We had a blitz call, and he blocked inside and got the ball outside on us.
And here's a touchdown. We missed a couple of tackles at the line of scrimmage, and they take it in for the score.
And at this point, when they add the extra point, each team has had the ball once. Each team has scored. It is 7-7, but you're going to see a big play coming
seven
up.
7-7.
Right,
watch Gunner. I hope we get another play of this, Jerry. We block this play. This perfect. We block it perfect. Steve Cox rips the linebacker. Abramus gets a defensive tackle. Steinauer blocks the defensive end.
77 yards.
David Imes is going to cut off the nose guard and get on downfield and get another block.
Here it is, replay, slow motion now.
Look at the block. Watch Lacy run over this number 22 here at the bottom of the screen.
Yep,
get
after him. Drilled him.
Mike Gunner can really run, Jerry. He's a 9700. You don't want to get in a foot race with him. Leading the nation in average gain per carry. Going into the ball game, averaging 7.8 yards a carry.
Flying down the boundary. On a first, I thought for a minute it was going to be an 80-yard touchdown run. It winds up being a 77-yard run.
Mike Gunner gets better every day he goes on the practice field. You talk about somebody that's working hard in practice and really determined to have a great football career. It's Mike Gunner. Number 22.
This is going to be an 80-yard two-play drive. Here comes Lacy to score.
Lacy right over the top behind real good blocking. John Kaspersky, David Pearson, Kevin Harlan on the left side of our offensive line.
Okay, we're going to skip down. It's 14-7
Gibbs.
Now.
Timmy Gibbs. Get after him. Joe Blankenship puts the heat on him. That's Timmy Gibbs. Sophomore defensive back out of Bigsby. Number 23. Put it in the end zone, Timmy.
Good inside blitz there and got good pressure and called the quarterback to hurry his throw.
I'll tell you what, it does your heart good to see the defense score like that. Number 23. Here we go again. Here's a replay. Good pressure. Timmy Gibbs picks it off. We're playing man coverage on that particular play. Timmy Gibbs picks it off. Who's that leading down the field? Dunlap, number 93.
So, school's been going on us all year about not scoring on defense. I guess we
let's score on this. Let's get some cheap points.
I guess we finally scored on defense for him.
Let's get some cheap touchdowns.
We're going to drop on down in their next series, pick up Banks, the ball carrier. We're still in first period, 21-7. I want to show you a little defense there.
Who is that? Albert Myers.
Right.
Number 48 coming up in his corner position, making a play.
Throw incomplete, caught out of bounds.
Jerry, we are really playing good defense right now. We're going to fumble this punt. This is one of the few times you're ever going to see Brent Dennis drop a punt, either in practice or a ball game.
No, this one, he's going to feel this one, Coach.
He's going to get this one.
Yep, he's going to get this one. And
the great thing about it, Bulldog fumble Warren, he came right back and caught another one, almost took it for a touchdown.
Now, that pass was almost looked like the big play.
You got to catch that kind, Kurt. We got to catch that kind. What's going on? Jerry, I wish you'd see David Hines on that play. He blocked the nose guard, got up, ran over the linebacker, and was looking for the third block downfield, giving us fantastic effort.
There goes Lacey for 8 after Gunner got 16. Scott Brown's going to carry this time.
We felt like they had a good nose guard, and our center and guards really did a good job on him. Number 50.
Next play coming up, we're going to fumble, but alertly get it back. Big run here by Lacey.
Big run, and that's David Hershey downfield being alert, falling on the loose ball. Got to wrap it up now, Cam. Don't fumble the football downfield, giving us great effort.
Now we're going to change ends of the field. We go to the second quarter.
We've got the win now. For the first time in a ball game, and I tell you what, as I mentioned at the top of the show, this is Rip City here. Rip City, great offensive football, going against the number one defensive team in the Missouri Valley Conference.
We're going to set up I think they got messed up on the routes, it looked like.
Stukrom. A little bit messed up. They came with a strong safety blitz.
Stukrom from 42 yards out.
That's just a routine field goal for Stu. 42-yard field goal.
And
that made him 17, I think, this season.
With the win, and too many people return the ball against Stu Crum. He's going to put it in the end zone every time with the win at his back.
They're going to take it here, Coach, and go score. It's not a very good series for us. I think we get a penalty in this drive.
We're playing underneath coverage there. We want to make them throw it in front of us and just play a little too soft that time.
Good defense that time.
They're going to come out here with a bootleg pass, I believe. Here's a little trap play. We missed a tackle at the line of scrimmage. Come on, close on that now, Ian.
That was our problem early, Coach. We kind of cold. It wasn't wrapping up. We were hitting them at the line of scrimmage. They were still breaking the tackle and going for 5 extra yards.
This big running back is 6'4", 205 pounds. A pretty good football player. Doesn't have very good speed, Jerry. I think his longest run all night was 13 yards, but he's pretty courageous football player.
Yes, he is.
There's Blake Borkman. Blake really had a good ball game last night. He had 10 tackles. They fumble a football there. We recover, but the official had already blown it dead. Fourth down play, they gamble, get the first down.
Here's another indication. We had him wrapped up, but he broke the tackle and got another extra few yards there.
Jerry, that's number 90. I don't think I've said enough this year about Tom Baldwin. What a great year Tom Baldwin's had.
Yeah.
Junior defensive tackle. Get Tom on a good weight program this winter. He's going to have a great football career ahead of him. That's Cliff Abbott, number 57 in on that particular tackle.
Good play there. Say the long gainer by a linebacker.
That's Brian Burroughs, number 47, making the tackle. Senior linebacker out of St. Louis. There's Borkman and Blankenship, two senior football players.
Indiana State just now just trying to ram it at us, trying to run at our linebackers because we run so well chasing the ball, just trying to run at us.
We overran the play there, Coach Jones. They had a cutback call. Our linebackers overran it.
Yes.
Defensive end fell back and missed the tackle.
24-14. Now, after an exchange of punts, we pick it up again in the second period with Tulsa in possession.
Running a toss sweep, Mike Gunner.
Next play is a nice play coming up to Harlan.
Boy, it's wide open. That's a trap pass. Their cornerback was playing real close to the line of scrimmage. That's Kevin Harlan.
We'll see it again.
Sophomore tied in out of Ponca City. Good execution, Scott Brown. Wide open. Lay it out there and let him catch the football.
It's good, tough running by Kevin.
You bet. There's Joe Blankenship out there. patting his buddy on the back.
This is a fumble.
What's Scott?
They wrestle for 15 minutes, and Scott Brown wins.
Scott Brown's going to come out of there somehow. He's going to get this football. I tell you, that tells you a little bit about what kind of person Scott Brown is. 57-yard field goal coming up, Jerry.
Yep.
Stu's got a little wind at his back. We're going to throw an incomplete pass here. I thought this was pass interference. Looked like Hershey's getting hit while the ball's in the air. But nevertheless, he didn't call. We kick a 57-yarder. Stu Crum.
Right down the middle.
Right down the pipe.
27-14, Tulsa now.
And here's a big play. We're going to make a good defensive play coming up here now. They run a draw. Miss a tackle, Coach Jones. Brian Bruner gets in on the bottom of the pile, number 96.
Well, a few passes. They hit a little,
Here's a reverse here that the trailing end should have been upfield enough to cut this play off, but the guy makes a move and makes his miss and gets some good yardage out of it.
Had two or three missed tackles on that. They're going to come back with a bootleg pass coming up. The next play, I believe it is. This pass here is incomplete over the middle. They run a little bootleg.
That'll be on the next play.
There's Bruner again. Bruner made a lot of tackles in the ball game.
That's the trademark of our defense. We're gonna have people run to the football.
There's a bootleg pass.
Bootleg pass I'm talking about. They complete it there. Got the ball on about the 44-yard line. No need to panic, defense. Just hold them. Get after them.
I know Coach Noel said that we bend, but we don't break. Give them a few yards. We're going to get tough when it counts.
James Dunlap, 93. Playing a little man coverage. Albert Myers, number 48.
We're getting good pressure, so he decided to dump the ball off to the back coming underneath there.
Fourth down play coming up now, Coach. They run a couple fakes. I think that's Dunlap again.
Jay Dunlap made a great play on this play right here.
Coming up, the big play of the ball game.
78X hit the X receiver right down the pike for a touchdown.
That play started with 11 seconds showing on the clock in the first half, and it just literally put things away. We'll see it again on replay.
Great protection. Scott sets up real strong, and he just throws a perfect, perfect football, perfect strike.
And Coach is going to draw this up on our strategy session a little
Jerry,
bit later.
Jerry, I tell you, there's nobody happier than Jim Strong, Coach Strong right there, because he has worked on that particular play every day, throwing the football, watch it in your hands.
That's
watch
my favorite Lacy. Picture right there.
That might get the big hit right there, the ball game.
Kenny Lacy. And that's going to bring us to halftime with the score of 35-14. 191 yards rushing, total yards the first half, 297.
For anybody that wants to see some offensive football, Jerry, you can see it first half.
And things are going to get better. Let's take a look. This is Scott Brown. This is three plays in. Scott picking up 23 yards.
We call that the load. Lacy's going to block the linebacker. Scott Brown's running on in behind him. We play real good offensive football the third quarter here, Jerry. We just don't convert. We get down one time and get stopped on fourth down.
We got a controversial play which is going to come up here on fourth down. On the placement of the football from the press box, it looked like he got the first down.
I thought we got a bad spot. Look at Lacy block that corner. Just run over. Run right over number 22. Here it is.
And this is it right here. We need an inch on this play. Inch, 2 inches. And I'm going to take a look at it again. It just didn't look like we got a good spot at all on that. But anyway, we're going to drop on down to Tulsa's next possession now. But we do get the bad spot and not pick up the first down. Turns out not to be a terribly important play with the lead you've got at the time.
We got a good lead, and our defense went out there and really fired up now. Maybe that got them fired up. I don't know. But we start off here on our own 4-yard line. Ken Lacy toss sweep. Scott Brown, again, a quarterback, number 13, running a hard dive to Lacy. Steve Cox, I tell you, I just can't say enough about what kind of season he's had, Jerry. He's playing here with cracked ribs almost every play. You wonder if he's going to be able to stay in the game. Trap to Mike Gunner. Good block, David Pearson. They get a face mask penalty.
Got a face mask on that one.
Pearson's a left tackle, number 70. Tall sweep. We knock him down. Mike Gunner picks up 8 yards.
Scott's going to throw the football.
Little pass here to Kirk Phillips and incomplete. Come on, Kirk. Anytime he touches it, you ought to catch it. Little screen pass, we call it, over in the flat to Gunner. Picks up some
another face mask.
Another face mask. I tell you, you're not going to tackle my one guy's not going to tackle my Gunner. Watch this. Gunner is ripping it right there.
You see
it? I'm going to tell you right now, we call that wing right 46.
Lacy's going to rip him.
Lacy's going to rip him. Lacy upfield here for good yardage.
17 on that carry.
I'll tell you what, Truth, it makes play calling easy when you got two backs like Ken Lacy and Mike Gunner.
Don't know which one to key on.
That's exactly right, Coach. That's the great thing about our offense. We keep people off balance, a little trap pass to Gunner in the flat. Oh, that's Lacy, number 5.
Lacy gets 6.
We throw the same thing the other way. Gunner caught it twice last night. Yeah, we don't block anybody there. We have a bad play. Scott checked off the line of scrimmage. One of our offensive linemen failed on it. We run the old fake here, Jerry. We've had this play in our bag all season long, and we didn't execute that very good.
We're going to look at it again.
We got two receivers here in one zone. One's supposed to be deep,
exactly,
one shallow.
Right. One man was able to cover them both.
One man was able to cover them both. You're exactly right.
They lose 10 yards on that play by that guy intercepting the ball. If he knocked it down, they get it for the spot.
That's a good point, Coach. We're going to skip out 3 or 4 plays, pick them up throwing a couple of incompletions, show you the TU defense and the good job that it's doing here.
Our defense is really improved.
Watch it. Get after it.
They call this incomplete pass.
Robert Estes, number 32.
Incomplete pass, so they call it.
What's his punt return?
It's nice punt return.
Bulldog does a great job. Makes a guy dodge him right here, right there. Makes a guy miss a tackle. Coach, he's averaging right at 12 yards every time he returns a punt. Now that's great.
Start another drive, Scott Brown.
We run the lead option. Glenn Watson gets 2 people on that play. Number 2, Glenn Watson.
Lacy got 7.
Hard dive to Lacy. He breaks out in the daylight, picks up 15 yards, another first down.
Another 15 yards. Here comes Michael for 5.
Mike Gunner, Rip City on the left side.
You got to stop the hard dive if you want to stop Tulsa University.
15. Here we come back with 14, a companion play on the right side. Scott's coming to the line of scrimmage, Jerry, and is doing a great job running the offense.
Another 8 yards.
If they overload one side, we go opposite. We go back the other way. Ken Lacy running real tough.
Sure glad I don't have to tackle him.
And we jump offside here. Scott did a great job mixing his cadence up last night. We caught him offside about 3 times. Here it is. We've got Gunner open, wide open. Don't execute that one. Mike's a little bit upset, as you can see. Same pass we hit last week for a touchdown. Pretty good coverage. Pretty good coverage with our defensive back, Stu Crum.
32-yarder this time.
32-yarder into the wind. And now he's 3 out of 3 for the evening.
And it is now the end of the third quarter at 38-14. We're going to drop on down in the fourth quarter now. Pick up Tulsa after they have again stopped Indiana.
A little dipsy doodle coming up right there now. Reverse pass. Got to catch that kind now. Yeah, we got to catch that, Keith.
Going to see it again.
Wide open.
Too wide open.
People don't know Kirk can throw the football. Kirk Phillips.
This is a good play. This
wide open, Jerry. We won't let North Texas State have a chance to work on that next week, see?
Well, he had 6 if he catches.
I'll tell you, this is the first ball game. We have really tried to score a lot of points, and we're trying to run up the score here if we can. We want to impress the bowl people. We've talked about that to our football team. Give them a chance to set as many records as they possibly can. Hard dive to Lacy.
5 more.
5 yards.
Fake punt.
A little fake punt. Benny May. Tell them what we call that, Coach.
We call it the Bumaruski.
Bumaruski. We're going to see it again. Kind of tell us what's happening here, Coach.
Well, it's the up back, as you can see, it's teed up a little bit. We snap it to, I think that's Kelly Beasley, and he hands it to the Benny May standing up in the line. Benny just sits, let everybody pass by him. When they pass by him, he takes the ball off the run.
Benny loves that play, Jerry. Benny May, number 44. Senior out of Fort Worth. I tell you, we all love Benny May. What a great career he's had.
Now watch this run. It's important. It gains 8 yards, and it puts Lacy over the 1,000-yard mark.
There ain't another football team in America that's got 2 backs gaining 1,000 yards this season. Ken Lacy, and I want you to watch the reaction of his teammates here.
1,000 yards.
What's Gunner? Gunner, I think, is happy. He's just happy for Lacy. What's he? I tell you, I'm happy for him. Ken's had a great career, and his wife Suzanne, little baby. Ken's gained over 1,000 yards ever since his wife had the baby.
That's right.
I mean, over 100 yards a game.
100 yards a game ever since then. There's Hamilton. We're dropping on down. Hamilton, 4 yards.
Eddie Rabbit, number 16. Eddie Hamilton. Good football player. Call a little trap pass. That's Eddie on the hard dive. Eddie Hamilton, Johnny Horton. Johnny Horton, number 33, catching the pass. Johnny Horton is going to make a great run here for a touchdown.
Yeah.
We're going to get a field goal here.
We're going to set up, Stu's going to kick his 4th field goal tonight.
new every time he kicks field goal, of course, it's a new record. That tied a conference record, 4 field goals in a game. The old cannon going off over our coach.
We were trying to wonder what that was.
Mr. Abramowitz brought a cannon down, donated to the university. Sid Abramowitz's dad, Colonel Abramowitz.
I feel it on defense now. Get the ball back for our offense.
Hey, Ford almost got it right there.
One of your defensive ends,
Steve Ford made a nice play. We want to just get the ball back, give it to offense, let them put some more points on the board.
We're clearing the bench here now. Come in, William Oliver, quarterback number 4.
We're just kind of skipping around on plays. Here's Horton for
Johnny
33.
Horton. We got Brett White in the ball game, number 40. First time Brett's been in the game. You know, he suffered a knee injury to start the season.
Here he comes. He's going to carry right now.
He's going to cut it back. Brett will cut it back, Jerry. I say right now, he will bend it back behind that nose guard.
Carried twice, got 7 yards a shot.
Looked like the old Brett White of last year there, didn't he?
He really did. Skip Ast came in and played.
Coach Coker wanted to put Skip in the ball game for one play. He's a senior. This is his last ball game at home. William Oliver now back in, number 4.
This is a good job by William. Just getting something out of nothing.
And Skip playing 5 days after arthroscopic knee, sir.
He really worked hard this week to get himself ready to play. Tony Leapart there, number 63. At left guard, good trap, good block. Chad Muirhead, the right guard. Pat Maley at center.
28-yard touchdown run by Johnny Horton.
Howard Robinson, right tackle. Rod Patton at left tackle in here. Doing a good job. Second offensive line. Johnny Horton, number 33.
Made a good move. The line.
I'll tell you what, he got in the daylight. He knew he's running north and south. That's what we like to see.
Good run.
It's exactly the way Coach Coker wants those backs to run. Get your shoulders upfield, run parallel. Your shoulders are square to the goal line, run north and south.
Another good young player.
48-14.
The final score, the University of Tulsa wins it 48-14, 24 first downs, 421 yards rushing, 555 total yards. My goodness.
They had 7.
Offense played great the first half. Pink D took over the second half. Take tomorrow off. One more big one left this season. Yeah! 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 Yeah!